You know, I want to ask you, why are you called the Killers?
Well, before a show, to relax, we like to kill someone.
No, seriously, why are you guys called? Why did you call? You serious?
Thanks to the success of their singles and debut album, the Killers were now on the map. The Vegas Quartet had finished touring for Hot Fuss and returned to the studio to record their next album. The album would be named Sam's Town, after Hotel Casino in Vegas, the sign of which bassist Mark Stormer could see through a window in his childhood home. Most of Sam's Town was recorded at Studio at the Palms in Vegas, with the finishing touches added at Criterion Studios in London. Sam's Town took heavy influence from artists such as Bruce Springsteen, The Beatles, ELO, and more. When discussing the album, Brandon Flower said he wanted to create an album that, quote, captured chronologically everything important that got me to where I am today. Brandon would make some bold claims about the record, such that it would be one of the best albums of the past 20 years, and it would keep rock and roll afloat. But did the album live up to this hype? The band was under pressure to follow up the success of Hot Fuss. The lead single from Sam's Town, When You Were Young, offered some relief to the Killers. Brandon said that when he wrote the lyrics, he knew it would work out. It all started when Mark Stormer started improvising a bassline. Fellow band members suggested a few changes, and it became the groundwork for When You Were Young. When You Were Young was premiered in the summer of 2006, and was officially released as a single in September of the same year. The song became another certified Killers hit, and is one of the band's most iconic tracks to this day. The song is most remembered for the lyrics, "He doesn't look a thing like Jesus, but he talks like a gentleman," making When You Were Young one of many Killers songs with religious themes. The music video was filmed in Tlayacapan, Mexico. It features a woman who is distraught to discover her husband had cheated on her. Brandon has admitted that the music video's interpretation differs from his intentions of the song, but accepted said differences. The music video originally started with the woman jumping off the cliff. However, this was not allowed to air on television, so an alternate version was made where the couple reconciles instead. The alternate version that does not depict suicide is the more popular of the two. When You Were Young was nominated for a few awards, just as the Grammy for Best Rock Song, but When You Were Young would only walk away with the Q Award for Best Video. Sam's Town was released on September 27th, 2006. The album was a success, selling 315,000 copies in the US in the first week. Reviews for Sam's Town were generally positive, with critics praising the Killers for the evolution of their sound on the record. Sam's Town did have its detractors, with some slamming the album for its departure from the British-influenced sound of Hot Fuss. The Rolling Stone would even release a 2-star review of Sam's Town, a decision that would age like milk, as the magazine's readers would vote Sam's Town one of the most underrated albums of the decade in 2009. In November 27th, 2006, track 8 on Sam's Town, Bones, was released as a single. The song was originally titled It's Only Natural before giving its current name. Bones is one of the most risque songs the Killers released, with Brandon singing about how he wants to have sex with someone. The Bones motif from the title comes from the idea of having such a close, intimate experience with someone, you can practically feel your bones on their bones. The Bones music video was directed by Tim Burton, a notable film director behind movies such as Batman, Beetlejuice, and Edward Scissorhands, just to name a few. Bones was the first music video Burton directed, and it features his trademark style. The Killers perform at a drive-in theater, electing to play their song instead of watching the classic movies playing behind them. The video also features a couple who strip off their skin, exposing their skeletons. The music video won the NME Award and Q Award for Best Video, even though the song didn't reach the same level of success as their previous single, When You Were Young. Come Christmas time 2006, the Killers decide to get into this festive spirit. Brandon said, "I was trying to think what the Flaming Lips would do if they wrote a Christmas song, and the end result was a great big sled." The song was recorded in November 2006 and features vocals from Tony Halliday, former vocalist of Curve and wife of producer Alan Moulder, who worked with the Killers on A Great Big Sled and Sam's Town. A Great Big Sled was released on December 5th. All proceeds from the song went to the Red Campaign, a charity organization dedicated to raising awareness and fighting HIV and AIDS in Africa. The release of A Great Big Sled was the start of an annual Killers tradition of releasing Christmas songs that would last until 2016. When the new year came around, the Killers got back into releasing singles for Samstown. They started with the track Read My Mind. Read My Mind started as a B-side called Little Angela, but producers Mulder and Flood weren't fans of the song. Mulder even remarked, "We're trying to make Peggy Sue into With or Without You." Brandon admitted the melody was too similar to Mrs. Robinson and that the lyrics weren't great. Mulder suggested keeping the template and writing a different song over it. The end result was Read My Mind. Read My Mind was released as a single on February 13, 2007. The accompanying music video was released 5 days earlier and was filmed in Tokyo, Japan during a break in the band's Samstown tour. In the music video, the Killers go around Tokyo interacting with locals. The video also features Gachapin, a Japanese TV character who crashes with the Killers in a capsule hotel. Read My Mind was praised by critics upon release, and even Brandon called it his favorite Killer songs in later interviews. Read My Mind continues to be a fan-favorite Killer song to this day. The last Samstown song released as a single was For Reasons Unknown. For Reasons Unknown was written while the Killers were on the road touring with Louis XIV. The song was recorded on the tour bus with Brandon playing bass and Mark playing guitar. This makes For Reasons Unknown the only Killer song in which Brandon plays the bass. Brandon credits the unique circumstances of the song's origin to the sense of urgency that the track has. For Reasons Unknown was released as a single on June 25th, 2007. While reviews of the single were fair, For Reasons Unknown is to date the lowest charting Killer single in the UK. This is probably due to the fact that For Reasons Unknown wasn't promoted as much as the previous singles, as the band felt 4 singles for 1 album was too much. Brandon later regretted releasing Bones as a single, and it wasn't included on the band's 10th anniversary collection Direct Hits, while the rest of the Samstown singles were. During an interview with Billboard in August 2007, Brandon revealed the Killers would release a compilation album entitled Sawdust. The album would include B-sides, rarities, covers, and remixes that were previously not heard by many people. 2 singles were recorded for the album. The first was Tranquilize, which was made in collaboration with Lou Reed. The second was a cover of Joy Division's Shadow Play. Sawdust was released on November 9th. Despite being a B-sides album, Sawdust was moderately successful, receiving fair reviews, and was certified platinum by the British phonographic industry in 2008. In the same Billboard interview, Brandon revealed the Killers will release another Christmas song called Don't Shoot Me Santa. Don't Shoot Me Santa was released as a single for digital download on November 27th. Just like with A Great Big Sled, proceeds from Don't Shoot Me Santa went to the Red Campaign. Don't Shoot Me Santa is more comedic in tone compared to the last festive track, with Brandon begging for his life as Santa threatens to kill him for bad behavior. The music video is equally bizarre. Ryan Purdy, who plays the role of Santa in the video and song, has Brandon tied up and ready to take his life. Brandon would have met with a grim end had his fellow bandmates not came in time to rescue him. The first 2 Killers records would prove to be successful, but their next outing would take on a sound unlike anything heard from the Killers before.